Looks like the athletes are going to be doing a little test firing here, kind of getting back in the groove of thing after having taken a break since they first competed earlier today, and then also viewing the targets. So that's what we're seeing currently, is them doing a little test firing and viewing of the targets before this competition gets started.
And it's a bit windy, and the light has come down, no?
Yes, so we're going to see that progress as the day continues, more and more wind, a little less lighting, so it's going to really amp things up and make things a lot more challenging for these shooters.
We see the Dominican that is going to shoot without glasses. It probably is because of the lighting situation, right? Because normally they use glasses to shoot.
It really just depends on the individual, and some people prefer, some people don't. I mean, obviously, the idea behind having glasses is to enhance that target off that background, helping you to see it before or as quickly as possible so that you can make quick work of it and hopefully hit the target. So it's really up to the individual. But yes, definitely something that could be playing into his decision is the lighting that we're seeing here at this venue in Peru.
The athlete from India doing the test fire.
We can see him hold his hand out there to measure, trying to set his hole point, just to kind of an added element to kind of get him better prepared.
And she's shooting with a Soli. I've seen many Beretta and Perassi's guns, and as well Krikov, but now he's with a Soli.
Hayden had a 120 in the competition, so he's shooting quite strong here, running the last round. So excellent form and really a strong competitor. I know he's been working really hard to make these finals.
They will check the targets, right?
Yeah, so they're viewing the targets, just showing them a pair so they can get an idea of the height. Their athletes are actually wanting to see the reverse pair as well, just so that they have an idea of what they're going to be facing going into the semifinal.
So the semifinal is about to begin. We'll have the official athletes announcement soon.
And this is the semifinal one for men that should be made known that... this is the first and the beginning of two semifinals until we reach the final stage.
Ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the ISSF World Cup Lima 2022 and the ISSF welcome you at this beautiful shooting range in Lima for the first semifinal of Skeet Men. On position number 4 with bib number 7 representing the United States of America, Hayden Stewart. On position number 3 with pip number 5 representing India, Param Singh Gurun. On position number 2 with pip number 3 representing Argentina, Federico Gil. And on position number 1 with pip number 1 representing Dominican Republic with Durarik Lembeke. The jury member in charge for this semifinal is Juan Palva from Mexico, and the referee in charge is Luis Valladares from Puerto Rico. Good luck to all of the athletes.
So this final is quite interesting. We have some with a lot of experience and some as well that are, you know, don't quite get here all the time. So this is anyone's game out here, especially with this lighting and this wind that we're seeing. That experience really is going to play into this final.
And it's about to start with the Dominican Republic athlete.
Derek Limbeck, obviously off to a great start, hitting both those birds as we turn to shoot the reverse pair on three.
And you see the crowd. They are really happy. They are supporting him. He did 4 out of 4. Really good start for him.
Gil has a lot of experience. He's been here before, having shot the Pan American Games. A great competitor all the way around.
And he was recently in the Olympics as well.
Yes, he was. Him and his sister, I believe, both shoot.
They shoot mixed teams as well, right?
Yes.
And he, Federico Gil from Argentina, he was in Cyprus, the championship before coming to Lima. So it's...
No bird there on that reverse pair. Obviously stepping off the station to regroup. Timer starting over again. Very solid hits for 4 out of 4 as well for him on this station. Now, on the min, you're going to definitely see a lot tighter competition here and a lot fewer misses.
So Gurun from India, the first double, the regular one, now comes from the reverse one. And 4 out of 4 also for the representative from India. Now comes Stuart.
Making quick work of that first pair. I know I was talking to Stuart before this final, and he was telling me about his son who's playing some baseball with, as well as excited about doing some fishing down in Florida. So lots of plans on the horizon for him. Hitting that target as well, so 4 out of 4
After the first stage of competition is 4 hits for all of the athletes. They just told me the Sports Ministry of Peru is here. That's why you see a lot of people moving with cameras and taking pictures. He has come to see the second semifinal where the Peruvian is taking part.
It's very exciting, obviously. I mean, the stands are full. The crowd is cheering these athletes on. You hear him cheering him on, hitting both those pair, or hitting both those targets, I should say.
And in every sport, when the government works hand by hand with the private sector, you see the results. So it's good that the government is involved and coming here to support their people, no?
Oh, most definitely. See Gil hitting both those targets. It's interesting when you watch the men's final, the timing is very similar to each other. Each of them stepping up, each of them having their own routine, but yet their timing is very, very similar.
No target. There's no target.
The wind picking up a little bit there, making that high house rise. He was able to go with it and making quick work of it as well, hitting both those targets. Stewart's now up on station 4. This first pass is really where the athletes are kind of getting settled in, letting those nerves kind of settle. Really a fantastic pair for Stewie there, going one really high, one really low.
6 hits for all of the athletes.
This is a tight race, as we would expect, amongst the men, and it's quite exciting to see these athletes really making quick work of these pair. You have a hit there, so obviously two so far with two more to go for him on this station five, the reverse pair. And this is obviously one of the more challenging pairs.
And it's...
As we see a loss.
And
loss.
It's a double loss. As you were saying, Prius is the more challenging double, the reverse one, and in that position, position number five.
And the reason for that is because we just don't see it in the competition. So we haven't been practicing it. We've been shooting all the other birds, and then when we get to the final, that's the one we get.
And that's a loss for Federico Gil from Argentina. Let's see how the reverse double goes.
This is really where the pressure kind of starts to build a little.
And that's another miss for him.
So far, we've got four targets on this station, and each athlete only hitting two as we go into the third athlete, which is Gurun from India. Ooh, something happened there. Loss.
He didn't shot the second one.
He did not fire for whatever reason. Maybe he thought that he couldn't quite make it. I'm not exactly sure. Not something you see every day. Dead loss on the second, so not a great performance there for him as he only hit one out of the four targets on that station, station five. Stewart up.
And perfectly done for Stewart, the regular double. Now he enters into a reverse one.
You can see Stewart being very comfortable out there, obviously having done this, but being very excited to be here, obviously. Nice pair, way to...
After three position is 10 hits for Stewart, 8 hits for Durazic and Hill, and 7 hits for Gurun. 10 more targets to go.
That was a really strong performance by Stewart to be able to gain that many birds on each of his competitors. He obviously has to feel very good about that station going into this last pass. Now this next pass that we have, there will be an elimination. So it is very important. Every target counts here as these athletes step up to station three. Having a dead loss on that reverse pair for 3 out of 4 on that station for the Dominican.
Now comes Federico Gil from Argentina. And that's a hit for him. As you were saying, those next 10 targets are crucial to see who will continue in the competition and who will be out.
They really are, especially in this last pass. With 10 birds, you really don't have that much to gain or to try to work back. So it's a few number of targets. So him clearing that station, he's obviously very happy. As we see the Indian now stepping up to the station three, making quick work of that high house pair. Missing that second bird on the reverse pair for 3 out of 4 on station three for him as Stewart now steps up to the station. USA obviously crushing that pair and looking to that reverse. He's in the groove. You can just see his timing is very consistent. He's moving very well to each of the targets.
And
ooh,
that's
there.
A miss for him. 13 hits for Stewart, 12 hits for Hill, 11 hits for Durazic, and 10 hits for Gurun.
We're seeing a little wind here now, going from right to left across this
field. It's changing, right? And now it's a bit sunnier.
Yes, sunnier.
And more windy.
but also have that shadow all the way down on that background so that the targets are really highlighted right now. Shooting that reverse pair on four. He's obviously feeling really good about it. Now you look at Gil's stance and how he hunches over his position.
He comes slower, right?
Yes. Position. Yes. That's really athlete preference. Obviously very aggressive. You see him throwing his shells or batting the shells out of his gun as he ejects them. Each one is so unique. I think that's really one of the fantastic things about shooting.
And Guron, the technique is more standing. You see him in a position.
More standing upright.
Exactly.
More calm. Well, maybe not calm. Maybe calm by by looks, but maybe not. And then you see Stewart here and kind of in the middle, not quite hunched over and not quite standing up. They're calling VAR on
VAR. The coach from the U.S. has asked for video assistance referee.
So that's one of two VARs that he's called.
No six anymore.
No six anymore. Just one in this final.
As we have previously mentioned, each athlete has two options as far, so the U.S. is using the first one. Right after this first semifinal, we'll have the second one, and we'll know who's going to be into the great final. Stay tuned.
We only have one more station and two more pair before they will start eliminating. So exciting. This bird is really counts for something. As there aren't that many left.
That's true.
Before the first elimination. We still have a few more passes, but you definitely want to be more towards the upper part of the pack at this moment.
There comes the referee. Let's see what the final decision is. And it's a hit target. Enter into the last stage of this elimination process is 15 for Stewart, 14 for Hill, 13 for Duraggi, and 12 for Guron. Four more targets to go.
One bird separates each of them as we go into this last station.
It's really, really close. And only three athletes will continue, and then two will enter into the final.
And only two more pair to go. For the first elimination, we have a loss there, and we're calling a VAR.
VAR, the coach from Dominican Republic has asked for video assistance referee.
So it's quite interesting. Obviously, a lot of VARs being thrown all of a sudden as we grow closer, as these birds count more and more for those opportunity to make that final.
As you were saying, Kim, there are the last four options, so each of one counts a lot. And they are really, really close in points, so it's crucial, each of one of them.
Every bird counts. I mean, that's the goal, is to be a machine, to do it 1,000 times, nothing different. And ultimately, that's what you're seeing these athletes try to do out here in all the elements that are thrown at them, whether it be the wind, the lighting, they still have to make that perfect move, that perfect hit on each and every one of these targets. So really incredible showing as far as the talent that we have out here at this World Cup in Peru.
And it is a very mixed semifinal. You see countries from South America, then you see Central America, North America, and then you see India. You know, long, far, far away. It's a really mixed first semifinal.
But isn't that what makes it great?
Exactly. What
it's
sport
so
is about, you know, sharing and,
yes,
you know, having boundaries. And oh, it's a loss, the final decision of the referee.
So it's a dead loss for him on that, as now he has to shoot the reverse pair. Obviously, that plays with your mind a little bit when you're out there, having somebody call that on you. He's got to regroup and focus here on this reverse pair on five.
And he does it very, very good. He ends up with 16 out of 20 possible targets.
three out of four on that station for him.
Yeah.
Gil up here. Just chipping the back end of that second bird, but still all the same on paper. Hit on those targets. Now the reverse pair.
And that's a no target.
Now we're going to see a little more interesting thing happen here as we see that sun dropping. We're seeing that shadow really play on the back of that, really getting dark. And you're going to see that bottom of that target really kind of come, especially on this reverse pair, and really be a challenge for some of these athletes to see. Hitting both of those, obviously very happy as he bats the shells away.
So he has secured, he continuing to competition. A good one from India. And now he will have the same reverse double that he missed both of them. He even shoots. So let's see how it goes for him right now.
Oh.
And it's a hit loss.
You saw that he shot that second bird very, very quickly. That's almost what we would call a spot shot. Not really swinging with that target. And ultimately, it was a lost target for him. Stewart, you can see, has a much slower timing, but still making quick work of that low house pair on five, and now working on that reverse pair on five. A little more timing spread out, but still hitting.
After 20 targets, it's 19 hits for Stewart from the USA, 18 hits for Hill, Argentina, 16 hits for Duraric from Dominican Republic. And thank you very much for Gurun, India, fourth place.
That dutching that pair on five really.
10 more targets to go.
Dutching that pair on five for Gurun was really put him at a tough challenge to kind of overcome there.
Exactly.
But fourth place, not bad overall in this semifinal as we move forward with what, 10 more birds until we make another elimination.
And that's a hit loss.
You can see him take just a little extra time on that second bird. Obviously, he didn't see it or wasn't quite moving right. Not really sure the reason, but at the end of the day, it cost him. Just see the timing and Gil in comparison to the shooter before him. You can see how much faster and how quicker he is, but then also just how aggressive he is to each and every target, really looking for that bird.
And they're calling referee that says dead. Good. Yeah.
So four out of four for Gil. He's got to be happy with that as he's gained some targets on the Dominican. Stewart up next in station three. We look at this high house.
He continues in the lead.
See that high house really climb there, catching that wind just a little bit. Stewart making a great move to it.
And that's a hit.
He's really in the zone right now, feeling comfortable.
23 hits for Stewart, 22 hits for Hill, and 19 hits for Duraric.
So we're up on station four here, and we're going to see these athletes shoot this high house double.
Yeah, the regular one.
The regular on four. Loss for him on that high house. You know, every bird counts at this moment as we really wind down to this last station. We got two more pair on station five before another elimination will happen. Obviously, Gil hitting that pair on four.
And now comes Stewart from the US. Entering to the last stage of this qualification process, Stewart continues in the lead with 25, Gil second with 24, and Durek with 20.
So the best that the Dominican can really hope for here now is maybe a tie, but I think that's very unrealistic to when you look at only four more targets to go before we have an elimination.
Now it's not even possible with this loss.
Yes. Obviously feeling the pressure, trying to gain some back, but just not able to do it here today. But still a fantastic showing for him. One more pair, this reverse pair on five. Hitting them both. You can hear the crowd cheering him on.
He has finished his competition with 23 out of 30 possible targets.
Just missing the final.
Yeah.
Just taking the nose off that target, yeah. Barely chipping it, but hey, we'll take it. It's all the same on paper.
And the reverse double for Gil.
Making quick work of that reverse pair, obviously. Four out of four. It's great, great shooting for Gil.
Stewart looks really calm and steady. Well done for him.
One more pair to go for him, and looks like he might have secured his, well, not looks, definitely secured
definitely
his
secure.
Position in the final. Missing that second bird.
We have the first finalist, Federico Gil from Argentina and Hayden Stewart from the United States of America. Congratulations. Now it's term overtime. Soon we'll start the second semifinal.
See coaches out here, some consoling their athletes, others high-fiving their athletes. It's kind of a mixed bag as we switch over to this second semifinal. Just a quick note that we have going on here. Just a lot of the people milling around, a lot of talking, a lot of high-fiving, a lot of the athletes just getting ready, dropping their shells off, the ones that are shooting this next semifinal, others emptying out their shells as they move on to either going home or moving on to the final match of the competition. So just a lot of great competitors just kind of catching up and trying to figure out what the next competition is going to bring. We see some of the athletes now, actually, from the second semifinal, loading up their vests, picking out shells that they're going to shoot. Some of them putting them in special pockets here for the reverse pair.
Test fire will now begin.
The athletes are taking the field as we can expect, getting ready to do a little test firing and viewing of the targets as their competition is just beginning. This is a semifinal two with four athletes that will determine two of them will go on to the final. Now, who those two are, we don't know yet, but
we will know soon. So we have from Italy, Peru, Denmark, and France. Hansen from Denmark. I've heard about him. He's a really competitive athlete. I mean, he has won a few medals around the circuit.
Oh, yeah. There's been quite a few of them here. And in this final, for sure, that have some experience and have been here many, many times before. But Hansen, like you said, definitely brings a lot to the table when it comes to experience. And I don't expect a lot of misses in this final as I think this will be a very close race.
Like the one we saw before, at the very end, Stewart ended up with 29 hits out of 30 possible. So it was a really good semifinal for him.
But that just really goes to show you the caliber of the athletes that we do have, the talent and the ability, especially as we move closer and closer to this final. I mean, we're really converging, bringing the best of the best in our sport right here in Peru at this World Cup. And that's what we want. That's what these athletes have trained for. And at the end of the day, the best of the best are who go home with the medals.
That's true.
See some test firing going on, each of the athletes stepping into the station, doing a couple gun mounts, getting comfortable, and really trying to see the target as they've had a little bit of a break between their main competition and the semifinals. So quite exciting. And most of the time they're swinging on this reverse pair, as that's a bird that they don't normally get in the competition. And they only see that target in the finals. So they haven't shot it at all this day,
they're
except for right here.
The targets.
I see Jack out there as the referee, calling the athletes over to a certain spot where we get ready to announce. I'll leave that to you, Carlos, as
official announcement is going to be very, very soon. Ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the ISSF World Cup Lima 2022 and the ISSF welcome you at this beautiful shooting range in Lima for the second semifinal skid men. In position number 4, representing France, Emmanuel Petit. On position number 3, representing Denmark, Jesper Hansen. On position number 2, representing Peru, the local, the national shooter, Nicolas Pacheco Espinosa. And on position number 1, representing Italy, Christian Cicotti. The jury member in charge of this final is Juan Palva from Mexico, and the referee in charge is Jack Burst from the United States of America. Best of luck to all of the athletes. Okay, so it's about to start.
Exciting. I mean, this is going to be an amazing and awesome final, especially with the crowd here cheering on Peru. You're going to hear them really get into it. Hopefully it doesn't bother the other competitors. I mean, that's something we always worry about. But I'm sure that none of the Peruvians mind that at all.
You see, they are continue coming in. The crowd is going to be supporting, of course, the local. But let's see how it goes. That's a fresh start from the Italian Cristian Cicotti.
Making quick work of that first pair. Looking at the reverse pair here on three. Very nice, 4 out of 4 for him. He's obviously happy as he walks off that station. Nicholas from Peru, stepping up.
He waited the second, no, the low house, the second one. He followed it a little bit more, right?
Just wanted to make sure, I think he got it.
Yeah,
obviously,
exactly.
The nerves are hitting him. Takes a couple birds just to kind of settle in a little.
Yeah, to enter in momentum, right?
Yes.
And 4 out of 4 for him as well.
Hear the crowd cheering on a little bit.
Now comes the Danish Hansen.
Jesper obviously pulling out that second shell from that upper pocket for this reverse pair here. He has an excellent coach, as Tori Brovold is his coach here sitting.
He shoots really smooth, right?
Yes.
Standing really smooth. Opposite from Federico Gil, we saw in the last game, more aggressive, you know?
See Emmanuel here, very calm, very easygoing, as he's not being super aggressive out there, but obviously still getting the job done. Ooh, missing that second bird.
After the first stage is 4 hits for Italy, Peru, and Denmark, and 3 hits for France.
I think it should be noted that the wind has definitely died down a little bit.
Yeah,
it's not
it's
quite
stopped.
As windy. We definitely have a changing in the lighting a little bit. It's a little less bright, and so I think these athletes are really looking for those targets right now. As we're on station 4, high house double. Hitting that pair, walking off.
Italy continues really strong. Same for Peru.
You can see the aggression as he bats those shells away. It's
after
really
shooting,
fantastic.
No, it's like,
I did it. I'm off, you know, on to the next.
Like throwing away all the nerves and all the pressure that they could have.
Yep. Jasper hitting that pair there. That high house went high, had a little breeze pick up a little on that target.
Six hits for Italy, Peru, and Denmark, and 5 hits for France.
So we're here on 5. The athletes are waiting for the ref to give them the A-OK to start. Jack has just told him to begin, so let's see what Italy does here.
And that's a
They're
miss.
Calling a VAR on that.
VAR! The Italian coach has asked for video assistance referee.
And you can see where that VAR is really playing out in these finals and semifinals. I mean,
it is, actually. So this is the first VAR for Italy. As you already know, they have only 2 options so far.
Yes, but every bird counts at this point.
After these 4 shots, we're going to be exactly at the middle, 10 targets, and then we'll have 10 more targets, and one of the others will not continue in the competition.
And really, every target counts in this competition, as none of
they
these
do.
Guys are going to miss a whole lot. These are pretty seasoned and some experience here going, so we expect it to be a pretty solid final. And that's why you see these coaches calling these VARs on almost every target if there's even a chance of them possibly being hit.
That's true. And this World Cup in Lima helps them to prepare to the World Championship, which is going to be in Lonato in Italy. I believe it's July, August, so it's coming next. So this World Cup and national competitions help them to prepare to this main event, the World Championship.
And it should be noted that the World Championships is where we're going to be handing out quotas and Olympics points and everything. So it's really where the Olympic run starts for all of these athletes and why you're seeing them so competitive out here.
That's true. Here comes the referee with the final decision, which is... And it's a hit for Italy.
He's got to be obviously very happy
with
that.
Very happy. You looked at his face.
Now, this reverse pair, this is imperative for him to hit this, so let's see what he does. Station 5, reverse pair.
And that's a loss for him, so hit and loss.
And that's an unusual one to miss. I mean, the first bird is usually the gimme when you look at pairs. It's the second one that's the most challenging. So for him to miss that first one, he must not have seen it or something went wrong for him on that station.
And it was the reverse double, the one that is much difficult. And this is...
Some of the athletes here are saying that he rushed his mount, but that, I mean, could possibly be it. I mean, who knows at this point?
It was a no target for Nicolas Pacheco from Peru. He has to repeat. And he does it very good in the regular double.
You can just look at his timing. It's a little bit slower than the Italian. If you notice, he's really taking his time to really see those birds. And I think it's really having to do with that shadow coming in off that backdrop and the black at the bottom of the target, you know, really contrasting off that background, really making it a challenge. Very quick on that.
Very quick, the reverse double.
Yes, yes. So quite different in between those two pair, which is quite interesting as he hit 4 out of 4. But still, strategy worked.
Yeah. And Hansen, very good on the first double.
Much more even in his timing. You could see it there from the first pair to the second pair. Really not that much different, but still 4 out of 4 for him as well. This is a tight race as we continue on here on station 5. You know, a great way to judge that is looking at those puffs. You can really see if they're far apart or if they're closer together as to how they're timing, if they're being consistent or if they're changing at all. And you can see on his pretty far apart on that last pair. And on that one as well, but still a
after 10 targets, it's 10 hits for Nicolas Pacheco, 10 hits for Hansen, and 9 hits for Cicotti, Italy, and Petit France. 10 more targets to go.
So this is the last pass before the first elimination that
exactly.
We have. So every target counting here, as there aren't a lot of misses as we move on to station 3. You see those puffs really close together, really showing good timing.
Christian continues really strong in his shooting.
You see him taking a big breath there, trying to calm himself down, this reverse pair.
And the time. And that's a loss for him, so hit and loss.
And you can see he took a little extra time on that, not quite seeing it, and obviously costing him that second target. Not quite the same timing he had on that first pair. He's definitely in the zone right now.
Yeah, he's shooting really, really good, the Peruvian Nicolas Pacheco.
Nicolas, really, really in the zone.
He's taking a lot of time right now. He has 8 seconds to go. Not perfectly.
So... He's saying dead.
So the referee, Mr. Jack Burch, says is a good one. So 4 out of 4 for the Peruvian.
And I actually saw a piece come off of that, off the backside.
Me too. A really small piece.
Real small piece.
It still counts. But
that's
you
all
saw
you need.
Yeah,
that's all you need.
You saw the crowd screaming, it's good, it's good.
Yep. Yeah. Like I said, it's almost like they help you to pull the trigger each and every time.
That's true. But the referee has the last word.
Yes, just for hitting that first pair, making quick work of this second reverse pair on station 3 as we move on to France right now. Ooh, you see that high house, catch a little bit of wind there and make a high climb. He went right with it. Great
they
shot.
They continue
from
really close in the numbers.
Very nice work of that reverse pair.
14 hits for Peru and Denmark, 13 hits for France, and 12 hits for Italy.
You know the old saying, you always win by one or you lose by one. And I kind of feel like that's going to be the case here. It's going to be a very close race as we wind down here to station 4 and only one more station to go after this before we have our first elimination.
And that's a hit for Italy.
On the reverse pair on 4, it should be mentioned, as they are in their second pass right now. So obviously that would be the reverse pair on 4 they'd be shooting. It's a loss
and
there.
And that's a loss for Nicolas Pacheco from Peru. So hit loss.
His first miss, I think,
his
of
first
the
miss.
Competition.
Yeah. Only Jansen continues 100% of accuracy.
And of course, Jansen has been here many times before, so we would expect nothing less.
And he's a really experienced athlete.
Yes, very calm. You can see he's not really pacing. He's just standing.
16 hits for Denmark, 15 hits for Peru and France, and 14 hits for Italy. 4 more targets to go.
So it's really, really close.
So the Italian Christian here really needing to hit these targets says
and
he's really feeling the pressure.
And expect someone to miss at least one.
Yes, maybe two. Which is quite a shame because he is bib number 2, so he did shoot very fantastic in the competition. Hopefully he can pull it off here. We'll see what happens. Getting a no bird on that first call and having to recall on station 5. Low house pair. Hitting both those targets and now looking to this reverse target, attempting to put the pressure on everyone else as they will need to run this in order to not eliminate him. So there was a call there by a referee that didn't reset the clock. So unfortunately that is a little bit of a distraction for him, something he has to overcome, but I'm sure he's done this before and will have no problem with that. Dead and lost for him on that. So it's not guaranteed, but he's definitely looking like he possibly could be the fourth place position. We'll have to see what everybody else does. They need to hit these targets. He obviously has a very high bib number.
Yeah.
They can't afford to tie him at this moment. Otherwise, he'd be the winner.
He qualified first to this second semifinal, so he had preference in case of a tie.
That's correct. Peru making quick work of those pair, hitting 4 out of 4. We have Jasper up next from Denmark calling here on station 5, hitting his first pair. You can just see the calmness in him as he's done this many times. He's not fidgeting, he's not parading around. He's just very to the point.
Perfectly done by him. 20 out of 20.
And walking off like it's nothing, like no big deal.
Yeah.
Like I do this
like
every day.
Like I'm shooting training and you're shooting a semi-final in the World Cup.
Yes, as well.
Yeah, and really experienced athlete. And yeah.
Well, he has 2 Olympic medals.
Wow, yeah. He has competed everywhere in every type of competition. In Europe, in the world, yeah.
Yes. Yeah, we were talking about Tori Borwold before. That's obviously his coach, who was also an Olympic medalist. I've competed with him many times over the years and has a lot of experience. So, I mean, it's a great team that you're seeing here play out for Denmark in this final. A lot of experience, both on and off the field. France having a tough break here as the target is coming out broken and having to step off the station and recall.
The first double for him, Petit from France. And that's a lost hit.
Looked like he shot behind that target, never really quite catching up. And we're seeing that light kind of drop here. So maybe something with the vision. He didn't quite see that bird for whatever reason.
Fourth place for Italy, Cicotti. And first place is Denmark with 20 hits. Second place is for Peru, 19 hits. And third place is for France, 18 hits. 10 more targets to go to know the finalists.
So as we were previously saying, he qualified in the first place. So he did a very, very good shot in the qualification process. That's sadly he's out of competition.
But, you know, unfortunately, that's just sometimes the way it goes. I mean, that's really what this competition is about, is not only how well do you perform, but how well you handle pressure and how you perform under it. And, you know, I mean, it's just sometimes it works out this way, unfortunately.
And the semifinals and finals, they start from zero. So it doesn't matter the qualification numbers. It's only to qualify into that stage. And then it's...
Nothing's carried over, unfortunately.
Exactly.
But you can see here we have Peru hitting the first pair on 3 and looking to shoot his second reverse pair on 3. Taking his time once again, getting dangerously close with the clock. Really slowing up on that second.
The Peruvian coach has asked for video assistant referee.
Being called by the Peruvian coach. You can see he really took his time on that second shot. We'll have to wait and see what the referees call, if whether it's dead or loss.
From here I couldn't see if it was a hit or a loss, but we'll see in a few minutes.
And as the time goes, we're really seeing this sun really drop now. I think it's something that should be noted, that this sun is really dropping very rapidly, and we're seeing that the challenges that these athletes are going to be facing as we go into the next 10 targets as well as into the final, being able to see these birds.
And here comes the referee with the final decision. We'll know soon. And it's a loss.
He's obviously not very happy with that as he comes off that station, kind of disappointed. Hopefully he can regroup as we have only 2 more stations to go. He's still in the game.
Here comes Hansen from Denmark.
He's so smooth out there on those pairs.
And he's shooting perfectly well. No miss for him right now.
That was a dead.
And that's a hit.
Dead bird. No,
it
no
was
var.
A hit.
The referee called it a hit. No var. So there's some confusion there, as some people were yelling VAR, but the referee actually was calling it dead, so there was no need for the VAR in
exactly.
that moment.
Exactly. So Petit from France, shooting really good. And Hansen continues on the lead with two different shots, two different hits, more than the other athletes.
It's a loss for France.
24 hits for Denmark, 22 hits for Peru, and 21 hits for France.
So we have station four now as we kind of wind down on this second semifinal.
Yeah.
And with
it's
the
reverse double, right?
Reverse double on four. Which out of the two on four is usually the more challenging one of the two. Not that we expect them to miss here. This is really one of the easier birds on the field. Nope, they're shooting the high house double.
Yep.
That high house really going high on him, catching that wind a little bit. He went right with it.
Petit from France.
France making quick work.
Entering to the last stage is 26 hits for Hansen, 24 hits for Pacheco, and 24 hits for Petit.
The people in the crowd are asking something related to the points.
Yes, so the people in the crowd are asking about and saying that the scoreboard is incorrect. So there's some debate going on that. But while that's continuing, Peru is out there. He hit the first pair. He hit
perfectly
the second.
Done. So it's 28 out of 30. Okay, so it seems he's going to be in the final for position, right?
Jasper hitting both those, looking to that reverse pair. Jasper hitting both those and running the semifinal. So we have some debates going on here as far as the misses and the hits, and they're actually looking at
the... Something is happening between the referees and the jury members. They are counting points. It seems, as I was heard, that maybe the French athlete had 1 point less and then they put it right. That's why they are discussing. We'll know the final decisions.
There's a lot of debates going right now in the stands.
Between coaches, referees, you remember
athletes
and viewers, family and friends who are here. Even us or not. What do you think about it, Kim?
Well, you know, I mean, in all honesty, I don't think it much matters at this point, as I think that, well, maybe it would, because I guess there would be a shoot-off, but
that's true.
There wouldn't be.
In
so
case. Yeah.
In case it would.
Yes, we had that debate, people. Yeah.
So it looks like they did deduct the target.
Exactly. It seems the French athlete had one less point, and they sum up at the very end. Yeah.
So they've corrected the scoreboards now. And with that, they are moving forward. So it looks like even if the French hits both these targets, he's still going to not have enough for the final. It looks like it's going to be Jasper from Denmark and Nicholas from Peru that will be continuing on to the final. But still, France making great work of that last pair, and now the reverse pair on five for a dead loss.
We have the two finalists, S. Jansen from Denmark and Pacheco Espinosa from Peru. Now it's turn overtime. We'll have the final soon.
You can see these athletes now really changing their lenses, really adjusting for this lighting. You see Jasper putting on a lighter color as well as some of the other athletes. As this light is really dropping now, as we have still quite a few more targets to go before the medalists are announced.
And cleaning the lenses and taking water to be hydrated and taking more ammo, ammunition. Yeah, they're preparing for the final.
Coaches are pumping them up and really talking to their athletes, trying to assess what to say, what not to say, but how to best help them in this moment as the pressure builds for this final. As you can see, Tori Brevold out there with Jasper, really having that conversation.
The Olympic medalist team that you say before, both athlete and coach, they're Olympic medalists. So it's a great team.
Yes, a great team with a lot of experience between the two of them. You see the USA coach, Jay Waldron, talking to Stewart, really trying to calm him down before this competition, as he's been training really hard for this moment.
So Stewart from the US and Federico Gil from Argentina, they will join the Danish and the Peruvian in the final.
Those back numbers are being swapped out and changed as we move forward in this next round of competition.
Yeah. In both semifinals, they had very high points. So we saw for Stewart 29 points out of 30, and Hansen from Denmark 30 out of 30, and Pacheco 28 out of 30. So it's really high qualification points in the both semifinals.
Not a lot of room for error there. Not a lot of room to make up if you do miss or anything like that. So at the end of the day, this is going to be really one by one or lost by one, I think.
Exactly.
And the competition is very tight, especially here in Peru at this World Cup, as there's some amazing talent out there.
We will know the medalist very, very soon. We are not really sure what's happening, something related with the referee, or you remember?
Something about pushing a button or not pushing a button with the timer. So it's going to be an interesting final as they're going to really, watch it play out in this final.
Let's hope the referees and you members are equal for everybody. It doesn't matter if you are Peruvian or not. They must be fair for everybody, all of the athletes.
And I think every coach and every referee is, at the end of the day, we just want to see the best of the best go home with those medals. And
exactly.
I think at the end of the day, that's what we'll see here at the Peru World Cup. The coaches and the athletes are all huddled together, and the referees and the scorers are all huddled together. It's quite a scene out here, and everybody's filling the stands. Lots of debates and conversations going. So there seems to be a little bit of a lull here while we wait for this medalist match. We see a lot of people on the stands filling in. We see the athletes milling around with their coaches and the back numbers going on. A lot of lenses being changed, as well as the referees getting ready. And there seems to be a huddle over there, a lot of conversation going on. The light is dropping. I think it should be noted that the wind is a little bit down, so we don't have those gusts that we were having earlier in the day. But all in all, it's looking to be a fantastic final as we wait in anticipation for this to begin.
So the final is about to begin, but they still continue discussing something related with the timer. We'll know very soon.
Whatever it is, we have a great technical delegate in Willie Grill out there.
Exactly.
Really handling business and really making sure everything runs smoothly, both him and it's been a great competition all the way around, so yeah, we really have him to thank for all the hard work that he's put in.
That's true. You see him walking around, running and coming up and down. He's like everywhere. And sometimes you don't realize that because he and all the team that is involved, you know, in the organizing committee and the ISSF members are back office. So you normally know that, but it's a lot of effort put in on organizing any big event like this.
Yeah, early mornings, late nights. I mean, a lot of work and dedication from Willie. And at the end of the day, we really have him to thank for this running as smoothly as it is and really coming together for a fantastic World Cup here in Peru.
Thank you.
So we have athletes now grabbing their shells. You see Jesper out there from Denmark doing some mounts and kind of looking at each station.
So we have now the qualification numbers. So it's Jansen in position number one because of the 30 out of 30 in the semifinal. Then we have Federico Gil from Argentina, second, third Pacheco and Stewart. Okay.
Four athletes going for three medals. Athletes are still getting their numbers, getting some ammunition. Looks like they're starting to meander out that way.
And it's a really good atmosphere, you know? Like, you see people really happy, you know?
Well, I think we're going to see them really, really happy at the end here.
Let's
after
see how
they win some medals, I tell you.
Let's see how it goes.
We have a really nice mix in the countries in this final, from USA to Denmark to Argentina to Peru. So
it's true. We see Northern Europe being represented by Denmark, and then we see South America, and then we see North America. You see, the athletes from South America and North America, they compete in the Pan American Games, so they know, like, from 3 years before this shooting range. I don't know if it had something to do with the result, but it's not quite normal to see two South Americans in a final of a World Cup. So maybe it's because of the venue they competed here before in the Pan American Games. So you all know, no, the venue. What do you think about it?
I don't think it hurts, that's for sure. I mean, having it be closer time zones, better, you know, closer to the food that they might be used to. I mean, their language, I mean, all that stuff just makes you feel more at home. And ultimately, at the end of the day, that equals to being more comfortable and, you know, hopefully bringing home more medals for your country. So we see the athletes lining up here as they get ready to be announced, which is all you, Carlos. I just leave that to you.
It's soon. We're about to begin. People are having a seat, preparing. The athletes are already lined up. Ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the ISSF World Cup Lima 2022 and the ISSF welcome you at this beautiful shooting range in Lima for the great final of Skeet Men. On position number 4, representing the United States of America, Hayden Stewart. On position number 3, representing Peru, Nicolas Pacheco Espinosa, the local shooter. On position number 2, representing Argentina, Federico Gil. And on position number 1, representing Denmark, Jesper Hansen. The jury in charge for this final is Juan Palma from Mexico, and the referee in charge is Luis Valladares from Puerto Rico. Best of luck to all of the athletes. May the best one win. Okay, all set.
We're seeing these athletes line up here, really kind of get settled in as the nerves are starting to, you know, work their way in. And ultimately, it'll be interesting. I don't expect a lot of misses. I mean, there's a lot of experience in this group, and it'll be a tight race, I think, to the end.
And Jansen from Denmark will start.
Once again, so smooth to that target. Really, his timing is impeccable right now, as you see those puffs being pretty close together.
And that's a loss for him.
First
not,
miss
not
of the
common,
day.
Right?
Yeah, first miss that he's had in the finals, from the semifinal to this. Obviously, I think it was a little flat, and I see him kind of batting his hand down, like maybe that was kind of either calmed down or maybe he just didn't quite catch it.
And that's a hit for Federico Gil, Argentina.
Once again, you can see the differences in their style.
Between Federico Gil and Jansen, right?
Yes,
the
yes.
Opposite styles.
Very aggressive, very crunched, very hunched over, very much in tune with that target as he hit 4 out of 4 on that station.
Nicolas Pacheco from Peru. The local shooter. That's a good double. Let's see the reverse one.
He's definitely feeling the pressure. You see him kind of pacing on the station, taking that extra minute to wipe his hands off and just try to calm himself. That clock is ticking. He's got a call before that.
And that was really close, only one second.
Yes, yes.
And he would receive a yellow card, right?
Yes, that is correct.
It's only 30 seconds to call for the target. So Nicolas Pacheco called it in the last second. And that's a miss for Stewart from the US. Now we have the reverse double for him.
He seemed a little surprised by that miss. He kind of took a double take at it, but I don't think he quite expected to miss that bird.
After the first stage is 4 hits for Gil and Pacheco and 3 hits for Jansen and Stewart. Now we'll have the regular double, as we were saying. No. That's a miss again for him.
Yes, and you can see he actually took a little bit extra on that bird, taking it a little bit later than he normally does. He's shaking his head at his coach. He's
Do you think it's because of the lenses he changed?
It could be. It could be. Yeah. Who knows? I mean, it's tough to say from here. Yeah. Gil is obviously in the zone. He's feeling it. He's crushing those targets. And same with Peru. We'll see how he does here on station four. High house double. Very much excited about that as he bats the shells away. Very aggressive. You have Stewie now. Oh.
After six targets, it's six hits for Gil and Pacheco, five hits for Stewart, and four hits for Hansen.
Perfectly done for Hansen. And that's another miss for him.
That's really unusual. I mean, obviously, three stations, three misses for him after having run the whole semifinal
exactly.
is quite unusual. So obviously, exactly. something's going on with him. Could be pressure, could be glasses, but at the end of the day, we have Gil hitting that first pair on station five and now looking to the reverse pair.
And that's a loss for Gil.
So oh, and he's raising his hand for VAR.
VAR! The Argentinian coach has asked for video assistance referee.
Coach is actually taking his cue on that and yeah. raising his hand for VAR.
Yeah. He looks completely sure that he hits the target, but let's see how the VAR shows.
I think he just told his coach, why not?
Could be. They have two VAR options.
You can see the Peruvian now out there shaking off some of the nerves.
He's like shaking and like throwing away, I don't know, the negativity or something like that, right?
Hey, whatever works, you know, at the end of the day. You see Jasper and you see Stewart pacing back and forth. That's something that, you know, Vinny really does a lot and something that a lot of athletes has kind of picked up from on him.
You're talking about Vincent Hangul, right?
Yes, yeah, sorry, yeah. I just...
Yeah, it's because you know him
so
really
much.
Close,
yes,
but for
exactly.
all of the viewers, Vincent Hancock is an gold Olympic medalist as well as Kim Roth, and he has won the recent Olympics, right?
Yes, yes, he did.
He's a skid shooter as well, and yeah.
And just an all-around just great guy. Just don't yeah. tell him I said that. I'm sure he's listening right now. So, Vinny, that was a shout-out to you.
No, he's a great athlete. Okay, the referees will give the final decision. Let's see how it is. And that's a loss.
Loss target for him. So obviously a disappointment for Gil.
Yeah.
Still not out of the race. We're early in this. We still have another hole pass. So quite a few more targets. But I tell you, with these men, every target counts.
After 20 targets... One of them will be at fourth place and not having a medal. The other ones will have either bronze, silver, or gold.
As we go here, though, I mean, these athletes are getting one step closer to each of, you know, winning a medal. So at the end of the day, There's a lot of pressure as we keep building towards this medal match and these passes and these targets that these athletes are shooting. There's a time violation.
Last time he was really, really close. Now he took more than the 30 seconds. So he's receiving a yellow card, which means the next one he's getting 1 point less, right? He's going for the reverse double.
27 seconds.
Yeah,
as the time
has
down.
Started. And he does it really, really good.
Hitting both those targets, obviously the crowd going wild behind him. He seems very calm, very relaxed about it. Almost nonchalant in a way. Stewart making quick work of that low house pair on five, looking to this reverse pair to do the same. Missing that first bird.
After 10 targets, it's 10 hits out of 10 on the lead for Nicolás Pacheco from Peru, 9 hits for Federico Gil, 8 hits for Stewart, and 7 hits for Hansen. 10 more targets to go.
So we're seeing these athletes really kind of spread out a little bit. One target really separating each of them as we have 10 more targets to go. Jasper's up here on station 3. Hitting the first pair seems to have kind of settled down into better timing and rhythm.
And that's another miss for him. Unusual, as you were saying previously.
Very unusual. He's laughing about something. I think it was the puff targets. Something he's trying to communicate with his coach. Something happened there, but he missed that bird once again.
Really fast shooting for Federico Gil.
Gil is just really in the zone right now, really focused. You could tell nothing is taking him out of that. He's hitting these birds very
four
solid.
Four out of four for Federico Gil, really good.
That was a great shot from the Peruvian shooter. Obviously, that high house going very, very high and him just going up with it. So really a fantastic shot.
Four out of four for him as well. So the Peruvian and the Argentinian continues in the lead. There comes the American Hayden Stewart.
I know I was saying earlier that Stewart was really looking forward to doing some fishing with his son when he got back. And I know that he's really does a lot of activities outside of shooting. So very family oriented. So I know they're all probably watching this and cheering him on back home.
On the lead continues Pacheco with 14 hits. 13 hits for Federico Gil, 12 hits for Stewart, and 10 hits for Hansen.
So we have six more targets to go.
Six more targets to go, a little more spread.
And that's another miss for him.
It's really unlike him to have this. He can't see. He's talking to his coach saying
maybe
he can't
glasses.
See.
He was the one that the only one that changes, so
maybe
could be that or maybe something in his eyes or
something. He's claiming it's his glasses, so I would probably lean in that direction. Obviously, two hits there for Gil as he comes off. Very focused as he walks back and grabs his water. And they're calling that a dead target.
Okay.
So, Peru.
Of course, you hear the crowd. They are Peruvian, so they are going to support the national leader. But at the very end, it depends on the jury members and the referee in charge.
Oh, well, I definitely saw something come off that bird. So, I think it was a great call.
Entering into the last stage of this qualification process, it's 16 for Nicolás Pacheco, still on the lead, 15 for Hill, 14 for Stewart, and 11 for Hansen.
So we're seeing more and more spread between the fourth and the top three, with Jasper at the bottom with 11, and the next closest to him would be Stewart with 14, so he's got a pretty healthy lead right now, going into this last station with four targets before the first elimination.
Yeah. For Hansen, it seems he's mathematically over. He's three targets, three hits of difference from the other athletes. So
still, though, Jasper hit all four of those targets coming off, doing the best he can, and that's all any coach can ever ask for.
He seemed disappointed, no?
Oh,
after shooting
definitely.
30 out of 30. Of course, he was expecting something more, maybe a medal.
Gill hitting that first pair on station five and now looking to the reverse pair. Hitting both those for a 4 out of 4 on that station five for Gill, and now Peru is up.
So now the reverse double for the Peruvian.
And we're getting down on the clock again. We're at 6. Obviously a lot of cheering from the crowd for him, his home country.
Family, friends, colleagues, other athletes.
Somebody in the stands made him smile right there.
Yeah. Now Stewart from the USA perfectly done this regular double. Now comes the reverse.
Very nice pair for Stewart to end on.
Fourth place is going to be for Jesper Hansen from Denmark. Big round of applause for him. Congratulations. On the lead continues Nicolás Pacheco Espinosa, the local shooter. In second place continues Federico Gil from Argentina. And third place for Hayden Stewart from the USA. 10 more targets to go.
So these athletes are obviously very excited as they know they're going home with some color of medal. Now, which one that is yet to be decided.
Yeah, we already know that they are the medalists, you know, the U.S., Peru, or Argentina.
Gill making quick work of that high house pair on three. He's still moving quite well, still very aggressive. Running the clock down, though, a little more. But getting 4 out of 4 as he walks off three. Really putting the pressure on Peru and USA to do the same.
So Nicolás Pacheco is shooting now. Here comes the reverse double. So he has been shooting many, many years ago. He actually won in this same venue in 2013, the Junior World Championship. So he's actually a Junior World Champion in trap and second place in ski. So he used to shoot both trap and skeet. So he's a really well-rounded athlete in shooting. And after many, many years, 9 years, he has another opportunity to win a medal in a World Cup, but now a senior.
That's fantastic. He just got a no target, so he's stepped off the station and now stepping back up to do this reverse pair on three.
And actually, he shot also the Olympic Games last in Tokyo, and he was really, really close to entering to the final. So he was seventh place or eighth place.
It's really fantastic shooting, going with that target, putting the pressure on Stewart as Stewart's now having to step up on three. So far, four for the first two athletes, both Gil from Argentina and Peru. One more pair for Stewart to do the same, this reverse pair on three. Can he do it? Hopefully, yes. A loss there for Stewart. So
after the first stage of this block is 24 for Nicolás Pacheco, 23 for Hill, and 21 for Stewart.
So now it's two points of difference between Hill and Stewart.
It's never over until it's over. We still have two more stations,
yeah,
but still.
Exactly, and six targets to be hit. So it's
still doable, but you know, like I said, these guys are not missing a whole lot, so it's hard to gain back some birds. See Gil there hitting both those targets, making quick work of the high house pair on four. Nicholas just chipping that first bird.
A little part of the plate.
Just nicking it, but it's all that he needs. You just need a piece of it.
Yeah. Now comes Stewart from the US. And that's another miss for him. A hit. Bar! The coach from the United States of America has asked for video assistance referee. So this one is crucial for him.
No? Yes, it is. It's really there's no room for error at this point. I mean, there's only four targets left, so everyone counts. It was a really smart move from the coach, but I do think he definitely saw something. I don't know. I'm in a bad position here.
I can't see. From here, it's different.
We'll have to wait for the referees to make the call.
It could be a small piece that we didn't saw.
See the athletes back here, both Gil pacing and Nicholas from Peru just kind of standing and shaking off everything, trying to keep the nerves under control as they wait to hear what the referees announce on this target.
So it seems they have a final decision. They are coming out from the competition office.
Seems like a quick decision on
this
one.
Yeah, it was.
Sometimes they're quick, sometimes they're slow, who knows?
Let's see how it is. And it's a hit for the USA. We enter into the last stage. So they give it right after checking the bar. So
the VAR doesn't lie, I guess.
Yeah, it doesn't lie. Yeah. So the four last targets to go.
I think it should be noted that the lighting has really come down. It's not really bright out here. I would say it's kind of middle of the road or early afternoon-ish. And we have no wind. I think the wind has completely died down, which is something we didn't expect.
And that's a miss for Hill. Three out of four possible hits. So he has finished with 28 out of 30 possible.
So it's looking more and more like Stewart's going to walk away with the bronze, but we'll have to wait and see. Ooh, missed that first bird.
So it's a first miss.
VAR, the Peruvian coach has asked for video assistance referee.
So as you were saying, each hit counts a lot. So yeah, the Peruvian coach has nothing to lose and something to win. So they have asked for VAR. Let's see. Maybe they saw something we didn't.
And each coach gets two. And obviously, that was the first one for each of them
exactly.
to use. So we're getting down to the end. And the coaches are kind of using these more towards the end as they count more, obviously, as we see, as we watch these finals play out in front of us. You see Gil over here pacing back and forth, waiting for... You know, his turn next, kind of trying to keep himself calm.
He's already secured a quota for the gold medal match, so he's a bit calm, you know, waiting for who's going to be the one that will fight with him for the gold medal.
Well, we need to remember that these birds are accumulative, so every bird counts for this Peruvian between him and Gil.
Exactly.
Definitely, it makes a difference in this next pass of 10, so... We don't know yet, obviously. Stewart's still in the hunt, but it's looking more and more like he's going to walk away with the bronze.
We'll have the final decision of the referee after checking the VAR, and it's going to be loss. So it's a loss for the Peruvian shooter.
It's a loss for him, but he still has two more targets on this reverse pair. And he's got a little bit of lead over Gil, so that kind of helped him out a little bit.
Yeah.
Gil gained a few birds there, or I should say Argentina.
Let's see how this reverse double goes for Pacheco. And he secures a spot for the gold medal match. He seemed confident. Happy that he's into the gold medal match. Stewart from the US. Perfectly done for him, the regular double.
Stewart's really shooting for the bronze medal here, but still a great performance, really.
He's a great
athlete. Should be very proud to walk away with that.
The bronze is going for Hayden Stewart from the USA. And the gold medal match is going to be between Nicolás Pacheco Espinosa, the local shooter, and Federico Gil from Argentina. 10 more targets to go.
So it seems two South American shooters for the gold medal match.
Really some great shooting out here. I mean, these guys are... Not missing a whole lot. I mean, they are right in the middle of these targets. 10 more targets to go.
10 more targets to go and just start. And for the region, as kind of a motivation for our young athletes to see them winning. So it's like you as a Peruvian, you as Argentinian, you can achieve greatness, no?
Oh, without
a
doubt.
It's an example for them.
Without a doubt. We see him getting 4 out of 4. Gil walking off. Referee calling that a dead. He took a couple pieces off the back of that target. Putting the pressure on Peru to do the same.
Both are shooting very, very well.
Nine seconds on the clock as we count down. 7, 6. Just always to the wire with him. No bird. No target, I should say. When I say bird, I mean target. I should clarify that, as that's kind of the old school way of saying things. I guess I'm kind of dating myself when I say that. Having done this for so many years.
The reverse double, 4 out of 4 for him as well.
6 more targets to go. Yeah. So they're going to be shooting station 4, low house double here. one pair on station four, as always.
So six more targets to go. And only one hit of difference.
Coaches in the
bar.
Audience.
The Argentinian coach has asked for video assistance referee.
The audience is yelling VAR. We're getting told that there was a white puff from the audience members here, so obviously people are seeing something come off that target.
Yeah.
The Argentinian coach took time to ask for VAR.
So only two more stations. We got one more athlete to finish up on four, and then the last station, which is station five, to finish this and determine our gold and silver winner of the match.
Right now it's a South American golden match, and as Kim was saying, so it's only one stage after this one. It's about to finish soon.
See both athletes kind of pacing back and forth, the Peruvian, Nicholas kind of jumping up and down a little bit, moving around. You see Gil still pacing back and forth, left to right, waiting for this verdict to come back on from the referees, whether it's a hit or a miss.
Here comes the referee. We'll know the final decision.
Looks like it's going to be a hit.
And it's a hit for Argentina.
Gil taking a little bow there.
Yeah, yeah. They are good friends. They have shot together South American Games and American Games, so they know each other really, really well. They have competed in many finals together in local and regional competitions.
You see the Argentinian coach taking his VAR and waving it around over there. Very happy, obviously, with that.
Obviously, they're really happy with the referee's decision after checking the VAR. And let's see this double for the Peruvian.
Calling it a hit as well, so it's come down to the last station.
Entering to the last station is 35 for Nicolás Pacheco having the lead and 34 for Federico Gil. Four more targets to go.
So it's one pretty close.
One difference between the two of them. Anyone's game at this point with four targets to go.
It's been a great final so far.
Gil hitting that first pair, really putting the pressure on the Peruvian to Nikolai to perform the same as him, so we'll see.
In case of a tie, it's a shoot-off between the two athletes. And that's a miss for the Argentinian. So Nicolás Pacheco has a great chance on taking the gold.
Two birds in his favor right now. Yeah. A little bit of cushion, obviously. We're going to hear a huge roar if it does happen, but he must hit both of at least three of the four targets to walk away with the medal. So it's a dead loss for him, and we have a coach calling a VAR, so we will see what happens.
VAR, the Peruvian coach has asked for video assistance referee.
So for sure it's the pressure, you know, like knowing that if you hit the targets you have secured a gold medal, then comes the nervosity and because there's no reason to, no?
Well, you just never know what's going through an athlete's head in that moment. I mean, that's really what we're training for. You see him out there, Nikolai, shaking off the nerves, trying to let it go. Everyone has their own technique, and it really just comes down to what works for you in that singular moment.
But they should know how is it going. They might know that if they do it correctly, then they win or not? Or do you think they don't know and just focusing on shooting without counting the points?
I think some people do know. I know I'm like one of those athletes that likes to know. I tend to thrive under pressure, but at the same time, I think there are some that don't. So here comes the referees. We'll have to see what they rule. Hit.
It's a hit.
Only one. So it's a dead loss, they're calling it.
Loss and hit. Okay, so it's one loss and one hit.
So he has to hit both of these targets here for the win, or the whether we go to a tie and a shoot-off.
And a shoot-off. Let's
the
see how it goes.
The pressure's really on. See him taking his time, really utilizing that clock as we wind down to this last pair. It's going to a shoot-off.
And we will have a shoot-off for the gold medal match. And competition continues.
People screaming in the crowd, go South America, you know, like at this point of the final, they are happy with every decision it goes.
Well, this is a tight race, like I said from the get-go. I mean, it's really down now to the wire. It's anyone's game. These guys are really putting on a great performance for this audience. And
so it's one double, and the one who misses and the other one hits, it's out.
That's it.
One by one.
Hit or miss. Sudden death.
Okay.
As we like to say in our sport. So if anyone misses, the other one has to hit. Or if they both miss, they continue. But if one misses and the other hits, the hit is the win.
Yeah.
You see these athletes both milling around. You see coaches running around.
So the shoot-off is ready.
So we see Jasper actually leaving this final a little early. Apparently he has to go run and catch his plane, his flight. So
and that's a hit for Federico Gil.
Really putting the pressure on the Peruvian here.
Yep. And well done for him as well.
You could literally hear a pin drop in the stands right now. I mean, everybody is just on the edge of their seat watching this go down. Now they'll shoot the reverse pair on three for a hit or miss. Both of these athletes have been hitting this pair pretty regularly in this final and semifinals. So.
And that's a hit loss.
This is an opportunity for the Peruvian to take the win. Can he do it? That's the question.
That's
hopefully.
The question. We'll know right
we'll
away.
Know. I think the audience will definitely tell us.
And we have a winner, the gold medalist Nicolás Pacheco from Peru, and silver medal Federico Gil from Argentina. Congratulations for both of the athletes.
That's huge. So happy for him, obviously, to be able to do that in front of his friends and family. The audience just going crazy. It's amazing. I think the whole stands are out there on the field right now.
Yeah.
It was a great performance for Gil as well. He's got to be happy to be walking away with the silver. Really, really fantastic.
I mean, both of the athletes are all of the athletes are great athletes. I mean, Jester from Denmark, Stuart from the USA, Federico Gil, Nicolás Pacheco, all of them could win the gold. I mean, they all are great athletes and well prepared for this competition.
So you see the three medalists out there standing, gold, silver, bronze, like they will on the podium. holding up their guns, just really celebrating and really living in the moment.
Me as a Peruvian, I hope this helps Peru to continue supporting the sport of shooting, because we may know it's not a popular sport in Peru as other could be. So with this win, we hope the government and the private sector start supporting and trusting the athletes in this sport that has given us 3 medals out of 4 in all our Olympic history.
It's
and
really
we
also fantastic.
Continue so.
Really fantastic. And I hope so too, as we see, you know, more and more of these youth coming up. I mean, it's so important to have that opportunity and those kids experience this. It's really been fantastic. Thank you, Peru, for allowing us to be here and to be part of this amazing
no,
thing.
Thank you, Kim, for being here. It's an honor to be with a 6-time Olympic medalist this venue.
Well, I tell you, these guys out here have performed incredible today, obviously really laying it all out on the line. And
you know the feeling more than anybody else to be at the podium hearing the flag and okay, the transmission will be over, but they are handing the mic to the athlete, it seems. They want him to give some commentation about some words about his win. So we see many people haggling him and congratulating him.
A little bit before he gets home, I think.
Yeah, it's true. But as I was saying, it's a great feeling. You know that more than anyone to be at the podium representing millions of people. It's a recognition to all of the effort athletes do daily.
Yeah, and I think that's the biggest thing that the athletes remember is that, you know, it's not just about them, it's about the country that they're representing, about all the kids that are coming up in the sport, and, you know, just what the future holds. So it's an incredible experience all the way around, and I know that a lot of emotions running high right now, a lot of tears of joy and hugs and happiness, but at the same time, a lot of hard work, dedication went into this moment, and I'm sure he's, you know, just ecstatic.
So we have Dania Bisi from the United States winning the skeet women event, and Nicolas Pacheco from Peru. We'll have the victory ceremony really, really soon. We continue seeing a lot of people there congratulating the athlete and having pictures with him.
Nico, felicitaciones, campeón de la Copa del Mundo en tu casa. ¿Cómo te sientes?
Gracias, Andy. La verdad que muy emocionado. Creo que ya me tocaba las últimas competencias siempre me quedaba por un poquito de repente un poco
well.
De suerte y
ya he las well.
Y creo que todo pasa por algo. ¿No?
Obviously being
la felicidad
the
de lograrlo acá con mi gente en mi casa,
and, you know,
no me lo quita
hard
nadie.
With all these athletes,
la presión fue
un
factor extra en esta final.
Siempre hay presión, a mí me juega a favor y creo que tener el apoyo de la gente me apoyó muchísimo.
En lo que respecta te enfrentaste nuevamente al Denis, porque tuviste un encuentro y en los Juegos Olímpicos. ¿Cómo vino esta nueva temporada?
Sí, Jesper es un gran tirador, logró la medalla olímpica en Tokio y en verdad todos acá son buenos, ¿no? Estamos en una Copa del Mundo con los mejores del mundo y cualquiera puede ganar.
En esa semifinal, antes de llegar a esta final, te vimos muy emocionado. ¿Qué sentías cuando ya sabías de que te habías metido a la final?
Nada, contento obviamente porque dimos un paso más, pero igual enfocado porque hasta el último plato nada está dicho.
Arriba Perú, Nico.
Arriba Perú, gracias.
Nicolás, ¿qué se siente de ganar en casa?
Gracias, por
más. Sí, igual, yo creo que